it's going to be revealed unto you, man.
All
things are going to be revealed in the end. If we're lying, hey, it's going to be brought out.
Yeah.
But we're telling the truth. America's about to be destroyed.
That's right!
By thermonuclear fire.
That's right!
All right, and all you so-called white people, you're going to bathe in that nuclear fire.
That's right!
Yeah, yeah, they can scoff, they can mock. A nuke's gonna hit their ass, man.
Right.
Gonna blow their baby apart. Nuke gonna hit their house, melt their grandma, their mom. They're fucking dead. Okay? That motherfucker can laugh. You can laugh when you see the missiles coming, man. You won't be laughing.
Yeah, baby.
Laugh now.
Back at Isaiah 62 and 6. I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem.
And Jerusalem is a people before a place. Just like Zion is a people before a place. Jerusalem is talking about his people. He has set watchmen on our walls. Alright? And we're out here throughout the four corners, man, on the streets. Watchmen. What are we doing? We're watching for these prophecies, man. The mark of the beast, the chip is being pushed, man. At a super level. A super high level. Go ahead,
back at 6. I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, which shall neither hold their peace day or night. Yeah, that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence.
And you that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence. So we can't be... Hey, now is the time to prophesy, man. Those of you brothers out there that have been sitting on this truth for months, weeks, years, and the Spirit is still on you, get out there, man. Don't make no excuses, man. Because the time is going to come to where you're going to be found out to be a reprobate, man. You're going to be found out to be a bullshit artist, a liar, a demon.
Matthew 21:28.
Yeah.
But what think you? A certain man had two sons, and he came to the first and said, Son, go work today in my vineyard. He answered and said, I will not. But afterward he repented and went. And he came to the second and said, likewise. And he answered and said, I go, sir, and went not. Whether of them twain did the will of his father?
The first one, man. The one that repented and went to do the work. You know? Hey, you're going to go through things in this truth. You're going to go through things knowing the truth. You know? Now, the one of y'all busting me outside, it has never happened to me. And what the fuck? Why y'all busting me outside? Don't allow it to happen to me. Okay? Stop doing the work, because it's going to happen to where a guy might know the truth or hear the truth and then veer off and then repent and come back and start doing the work, you know. But guys that do the work and they stop doing the work, you're not justified, man. The one that's justified,
the line of Judah,
the one that is justified is the one that does the work, does the will of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. That's what the Lord is dealing with, the one that's doing the work.
He had two sons, and he told the one, hey, go out in my vineyard and work. One of them, he said, I'm not going to do it, but he went and did it anyway. Right? So he went out, he did the work. The other one said he would. That's how a lot of you guys are. You want to give all that lip service, man, just like that in Mexico. Oh, see, I need this, I need some money for this, I need some help with this, I'm going to go out this week, I'm going to go out next week, I'm going to go out in a month. All right, by the end of December, I'm going to go out. What? He never went out, man. So he never did the will of the Heavenly Father, man. And he was getting plagued with dreams and destruction, man.
Who would I do?
So you gotta, look, if you've been watching this thing and the Spirit's on you, to come out here and do this, man, you gotta do it. Otherwise, you're gonna be that second son. Right? Because we're all children of Yahweh Bashem outside of Israelites. If you're Jake. Alright? But not everyone is of the same stock, man. Not everybody is of the elect. So you gotta make your calling and election short. The only way you can do that is by being diligent. Being diligent is coming out here on the highways and the byways. Alright, studying, reading, and getting your came up, man, so that you can do this thing in all human sincerity.
So, yeah, you have to be predestined. The foundation of the world, that's what it really all goes down to. What it all boils down to is being part of the elect. If you're not part of the elect, you're gonna get disenchanted, man. And that's what we pray, that we are part of that number. Okay, whether we have to be a martyr or not, it just be a beautiful thing to be part of that number. But if you're not, you're gonna get disenchanted.
Isaiah 62:7, and give him no rest till he establish, until he make Jerusalem and praise the earth.
Yeah, we're not supposed to give the Lord no rest, man.
Thank you, God.
Give the Lord no rest. We're constantly complaining, El Bash, me, El Shai, to come get us, man. Until he make it Jerusalem and praise the earth, till we get the kingdom, man. Until we see our enemies driven before us, man. And we don't give Esau no rest, man. All right? We give the right and the left hand no rest, man. Constantly doing the work. Okay, the apostles made it. You gotta do 3 videos a week. Okay? Now nothing should get in the way of you doing those 3 videos a week. All right? You know? And the Alba Shimei Al-Shai gonna kill jokesters, man. He gonna kill jesters. Okay? Instead of the time to be fucking playing, man.
What? It's not a joke.
You got something?
Bring up a couple real quick.
What comes from the heart reaches the...
This is Proverbs.
Proverbs.
1.
David.
And 20. Wisdom cried without, she uttered her voice in the streets.
Yeah, wisdom cried without, she uttered her voice in the streets. And that's where we're at. We're in the streets. Reach this word. Okay, that's where you're going to find the wisdom. Okay, a man on the street. Men on the street preaching the word. In the correct doctrine.
Proverbs 1:20. Wisdom cries without. She uttered her voice in the street. She cries in the chief place of concourse and the openings of the gate. In the city she uttered her words, saying, how long, you simple ones, will you love simplicity?
Yeah, in the openings, the gates. Okay, right there you got San Pedro Square, the streets, all right, the cheap place of concourse. It's all types of businesses around here, man. All types of markets. This street up here is called Market Street. Okay, why? It's a cheap place of concourse.
Okay.
Where the word must be preached. Okay?
Going straight, narrow the way.
She cried in the chief place of concourse and the openings of the gates. In the city she uttered her words, saying, how long, you simple ones, will you love simplicity?
How long, you simple Israelites, are you going to love simplicity?
Oh!
How long are you going to be
simple? Oh! That's
your remain fucked up of your mind. And just jack out your butt the fuck out.
Right!
Thinking it's a joke.
Ain't no joke.
Thinking it's a joke. Watching the so-called white man balls on your monkey ass, man. Watch the so-called white man put
you
in a
concentration camp. You gotta talk to him like that.
Puts you in a FEMA camp. Puts jumper cables on your nutsack. And shocks the shit out of you.
Deport your ass.
Deports all you fucking speak.
That's right.
Glory, glory.
Right?
That's how
the Lord is gonna kill 2,000 people.
That's how you gotta talk to him.
Why? Because your people are rebellious.
We are.
Why? Because your people are evil. All right, the Lord gonna kill 2,000 of his people. Glory to your so-called white people.
Right!
Glory! Look who your president is.
Okay. Glory, glory! This is Isaiah 10:5. Oh, Assyrian, the rod of my anger.
Yeah, the Assyrian is the rod of the Lord's anger. Which back then was the ancient Assyrian. Get Nebuchadnezzar in there.
I feel Nebuchadnezzar.
But the modern
Daniel,
Assyrian
Daniel,
is the so-called
Daniel
white
Daniel and the lion's den. He said, I sat down, great
and the staff prophet. In their hand is mine indignation.
And the staff in his hand is the rod of his indignation. This thing I'm going to hit over the head with the billy club, man.
Right!
This thing I'm going to get shot.
That's right!
Freaks. Okay, you keep playing with the Lord's word.
And the lion.
Read again.
Oh, Assyria,
nobody
the rod of mine anger. And the staff in their hand is mine indignation.
The staff in his hand is that gun the cop has, all right? And you're going to use it against dumb niggas, man. Go ahead.
I will send him against a hypocritical nation.
A hypocritical nation. He over here quoting scriptures, but he don't know the scriptures. He got a cross on his neck, don't know what it means. Okay? You know what it means? It means 2/3 of y'all was killing the Lord. You put the Lord on that cross. That's why you wear that cross. Go ahead.
And against the people of my wrath will I give him a charge.
Yeah, he's gonna give a charge to these so-called white people to come against 2/3 of his people. Against Zechariah 13:8. Father for shot. Keep going.
To take the spoil and to take the prey and to tread them down like the mire of the street.
To tread them down like the mire of the street. Mire is shit. They're gonna tread you down like shit in the streets. They're gonna tread you niggas down like shit in the streets. Run your ass over with tanks. Run your bitch ass bald-headed mama over with the tank. Okay? If you got children, they gonna kill them in front of you. Why? Because you're scoffing against the word. Go ahead.
It's like Zechariah 13:8. And it shall come to pass that in all the lands of the Lord, 2/3 thereof shall be cut off and die.
2/3 of our people are cut off and they're gonna die. In the land, which that land is America. Okay? You're gonna die. Isaiah 13:2.
See?
I believe.
But you think I'm lying? But I'm the one that's supposed to lie.
God, Zechariah 13:8. But it shall come to pass that in all the lands of the Lord, 2/3 therein shall be caught up and die.
2/3 of the pizza, 2/3 of the whole nation of Israel that are here in America are going to be cut off and die. Okay. You're going to get chased by wild animals.
Jeremiah 15:2. And it shall come to pass, if they say unto thee, whither shall we go forth? Then thou shalt tell them, thus saith the Lord, such is for death to death, such is for the sword to the sword, and such as for the famine to the famine. And such as for the captivity to the captivity.
Yes, so when you bug down Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, so-called, come up in the day, in that day, when you come up and you ain't in the right spirit, we're going to tell you, well, the sword going to get you, which is these devils carrying these cop cars, man, when they unleash these troops out here during martial law, or these wild dogs that come. It's going to be mountain lions come out here in these cities, man. It's going to be packs of pit bulls eating you people, man. All the animals in the San Jose Zoo gonna come out here, man. Gorillas gonna be beating, eating white babies up.
That's right!
Gonna be beating black niggas up.
That's right!
Latino niggas up.
That's right!
Native American niggas up.
That's right!
Why? Because you wanna come up against the Lord and his men.
Glory!
Verse 3. And I will appoint over them 4 kinds, saith the Lord.
Crazy.
The sword to slay, and the dogs to tear, and the fowls of the heaven, and the beasts of the earth to devour and destroy.
Hey, that's what you niggas got to look forward to, man. Big ass ravens coming out, in packs, in swoops, pecking your eyeballs out, eating you alive. Okay, wild dogs, wild animals you've never seen before, coming out of nowhere to eat you, man. You, your wife, your children, your grandma, your moms. The Lord don't discriminate, man.
No, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. He wants you to give his life unto you. Do unto me as I would do unto you.
This is 2 Peter 2:12. But these, as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed.
Yeah, natural brute beasts. That's what 2/3 of our people are. They're animals, man. Savages. Natural brute beasts.
But these, as natural brute beasts, made to be taken and destroyed.
Made to be what?
Taken and destroyed.
Made to be what?
Taken and destroyed.
So 2/3 of our people, as natural brute beasts, were made to be taken and destroyed. Made to be taken and destroyed. Okay. And we gotta suffer all this, but it's all good.
When we cuss, we don't have to cuss. because that's the only words they understand.
And destroy, speak evil of the things that they understand not.
Yeah.
See?
Speaking evil of things they understand not, man. You don't understand what we're actually doing out here. You don't understand what we're actually doing out here, man. Okay, we're preaching the downfall of America, man. The downfall of all you nations here in America. The death and slaughtering of 2/3 of our people. Okay, the uplifting of our people, of the elect. All right, which those are the sincere ones. Every nigga a star, but every nigga ain't sincere.
But I'm the one that's fucked up, nigga.
You are. Hey.
And destroy, speak evil of the things that they understand not.
You see, evil of things they understand not. What we're out here doing is preaching the word.
Rastafari.
Doing a good thing.
Rastafari.
Doing a good thing.
Rastafari.
But you got bug outs all throughout the streets. Bug outs. Natural groupies that are made to be tested and destroyed. Bug outs. Looking like Sideshow Bob. And looking like El Tigre Negro, man. The Black Tiger. That's the Black Tiger. I ain't never seen a Black Tiger until today. No, the Black Tiger, not the Tiger.
Okay. Yeah. And destroy, speak of evil, the things that they understand not, and shall utterly perish in their own corruption.
The things that you do that are corruptible, you're going to die in that. And the Lord going to destroy you, man. Okay? Whether it's by the thermonuclear missiles, your woman, Lord can put a cannibalistic spirit on your woman and have her eat you, man. Hey, woman is
the
king
of
evil,
man. And shall receive the reward of the unrighteousness, as they that counted pleasure to write in the daytime, spots they are and blemishes, sporting themselves with their own deceivings while they feast with you.
Yeah, and a lot of our people are deceitful, man. Two-thirds of our people are just bogged down, not sincere, man. Okay, they come up here, they might glory the Lord with mouth. Might come up here and think they're doing a good thing. What he's doing is really evil. Get Ecclesiastes 9:28.
Is it true? You know his word.
Ezekiel 39, Ecclesiastes
28. Okay, cut. This is Ecclesiastes 39 and 28. So watch it. There be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in the fury lay on sore strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made them.
Yeah, so read it slow, start a little.
Got it. Sirach 39 and 28. There be spirits that are created for vengeance.
And the Lord created certain spirits for vengeance on the earth. One spirit of vengeance that he created was the so-called white man. Okay, the so-called white man was created to come up against our people for their disobedience. He said the Assyrian, he's going to send them after a hypocritical nation. Our people are hypocrites, man. Our people say they believe in the Bible.
I'm not a
hypocrite. Our people say they believe in the Bible. But when they go home, they're doing all types of wickedness, man. Our people read the Bible and tell them, oh, not to commit adultery. As soon as he goes home, he's trying to have sex with another man's woman. 2/3 of our people, man. Okay? So the Lord created spirits of vengeance, which right now is the so-called white man, ultimately, man. But then he got serial killers. Rapists, mass murderers.
But I'm the one who's a dirty rotten nigga, right?
Those things,
priests.
Those people are paid for vengeance. And vengeance is payback.
All right. And I like how you mix
it. This is Baruch 4:25. My children, suffer patiently the wrath that has come upon you from the Most High. For thy enemy hath persecuted thee, but surely thou shalt see his destruction and shall tread upon his neck.
Yes, so this wrath came upon us because of our disobedience. And though they're coming up against us right now, the Lord will give us power soon to tread upon their necks. We're going to tread upon you devil's necks, man. I'm eating my snakes, and your other nation's necks. And Judah's a lion's whelp. His hand shall be in the neck of his enemy.
And when Judas found out when he betrayed Jesus, he took all that money.
There be spirits that created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes.
When you watch them two animals attack people, kill people, that was a spirit of vengeance the Lord put on that animal to kill that person. Man. When a serial killer goes and he kills somebody, all right, that was an act of the Lord.
In the time of destruction, they pour out the sword and appease the wrath of him that made them.
So in the time of vengeance, in the time of their appointments, they pour out their wrath from Yahweh Bashem Yahushai to appease the wrath of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. So the Lord created these spirits to kill people as part of the judgment on the earth for himself, to appease his wrath.
Fire and hail and famine and death, all these were created for vengeance.
All those things were created for vengeance. Fire, famine, death. Okay.
Teeth of wild beasts.
And any beast could be wild. Okay, your pet could go wild one day. Alright.
As long as I can fly.
Yeah, I got testament too. I had a friend who had a wild, wolf, half dog, half wolf. That shit was wild, man. It would just be chilling. Next thing you know, it would just start biting things.
That's what I like.
We would just be like, what the fuck?
I like when you
know, just like,
spend the truth and we cut.
Just start killing.
Because I'm not a hypocrite.
You're a domesticated animal. The Lord can just put a spear on
you. I like that.
Jump on his own throat.
I like when you
teeth of wild beasts and scorpions, serpents and the sword, punishing the wicked to destruction.
Punishing the wicked of our people to destruction and the other nations. You're going to get punished by the judgment of the Lord. We're in the days of vengeance, in which the Lord is coming to redeem his elect and judge this world. All right?
Isaiah 14:9, it says, hail from beneath is moved thee to meet thee at thy coming, and stirreth up the dead to thee, even all the chief ones of the earth, and hath raised up from their thrones all the kings of the nations.
We could kind of tie this together with what was going on, man, because we're talking about spirits of vengeance, all right? Now, the Lord created spirits of vengeance who in the time of the Lord's wrath lay upon sore strokes. Now, the kings of these other nations, they're going to lay sore strokes upon America, man. All right? Now, that's what it's talking about right here, because when it goes into hell from beneath being moved to meet thee, it's talking about the so-called white man, the Edomites.
No,
all right,
no.
The grave is being
good and
moved
bad
underneath
everybody.
The worms are being spread
to me.
All right, to meet thee at thy coming. All right,
just
it says it stirs up the dead for these other nations. Even all the chief ones of the earth have raised up from their thrones all the kings of the nations to do what? To destroy America. Man. All right, to get rid of this place. That's why all these people here that you see before us is going to be destroyed by nuclear missiles. And World War III is coming, and America's going to lose.
That's right.
Am I lying?
It's Obadiah chapter 1, verse 6. How are the hidden, how are the things that Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought up?
God, and as a spirit, that's what you see with the international community right now. What's going on right now with Iran and North Korea? They're all saying, fuck America. Here it is, Donald Trump says, we're making Iran.
That's your motherfucking president.
We're going to be talking, right? The king of Babylon, right?
I'm about to
we're
going to
make a promise,
out.
Right? And then we're going to back out of it. Hey, North Korea, the Korea.
Koreans are looking at that crazy. Like, what the hell? This nigga just fucking just promised something, and now he's gonna back up. Hey man, all these nations are starting to realize who you are, Issa. What America does, you know? Nothing new for the Native Americans, nothing new for the Latinos, nothing new for the so-called blacks, right?
Freeze.
We already know what you white people do to us, alright? You know what you've been doing to us, what you constantly do to us, what you will do to us, alright? You piece of shit, alright? So now all these other nations are starting to realize what the deal is with you assholes, man, alright? So,
Psalm 58:3, the wicked are estranged from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies.
Exactly, that's all America for you. Here it is. Can you get a second?
Prophet.
Yeah, here it is. These people right here, oh, they do all kinds of wickedness. It's about all the history books. You go to class, they'll teach you about the slave, slave trade, teach you about how they killed the Native Americans. They'll teach you how they took Mexico, Arizona, New Mexico, right? And then they'll tell you all this, but these white people are proud as fuck.
Y'all took y'all
well, that's in the past.
Backwards.
But you know what? Leave them bygones be bygones, all right? Hey, man, what's your scripture to say?
Bygones be bygones. I try to be nice to people. Sorry. Still.
Cut. Yeah, exactly, because they hold themselves as guilty, right?
But I'm still
and
so mad.
So we're all seeing
it
right now that these nations are finally realizing what we always known. Since the white man got here, since the white man put, you know, Judah and the other southern tribes in slavery, all right? We've been knowing what the fuck you up to. We know you're a piece of shit liar, all right? You know you never hold your word. You know you break every single covenant, every single treaty like you did with the Native Americans, all right? Nothing new under the sun, you asshole.
Zechariah 11:5, whose oppressors slay them and hold themselves not guilty, and they that sell them say, blessed be the Lord, for I am rich, and our own shepherds pity them not.
Exactly, that's a white man, all right? And then only that, scripture also say, hey, I'm sore displeased with the heathen who forward the affliction, which is the Asians, the Indians, piece of shit. Anybody who's not a black, Latino, Native American is a fucking heathen who's been helping nothing but the white man put hell on us, all right? Here is a piece of shit Chinese who doesn't even speak anything about English, and he's walking up and down, and he's making more money than all of us. Alright? Blacks been fucking here for what? 300 years and still can't get a fucking good job! Alright? Why is that? Because it's fucking white men, alright? And it's fucking heathens! Alright? That's why! Alright? And they hold themselves not guilty! Alright? Oh, my bad. You know, I'm sorry. You know, I just came to America. I didn't have nothing to do with that. And fuck you people, man!
That's right. This is Ecclesiastes 3:15.
It says, that which hath been is now, and that which is to be hath already been. And Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, Bashem Rakakadosh, requireth that which is past.
Exactly. All right. The scriptures say, hey, you know, the only way to cleanse the place is with the blood that shed it. All right. Same thing with this place. That place is going to be utterly destroyed. All right. It is the ultimate condemnation for this fucking place for all the bullshit it's done. It's incalculable what Esau has done. You know, people always say it's off the charts. That shit's up the fucking, I don't even, you can't, there's no, it's up the Richter scale, bro. Right? You know, there's the only way to recompense this place for all the wickedness, which is unable to pay back, all right? Even if they were to give us reparation, even if they were to give us back the land, all the shit they've been doing for the past 500 years, there's no way in hell you'll be able to pay for it. So what? The reward for that is utter destruction. You gotta do utter evil. Hey, here is utter judgment, all right, coming to you, Esau. And after 1,000 years of being nothing but a piece of shit slave for us, all right, working the fields, doing meaningless tasks, working dead-end jobs, all right, we're gonna put your ass in fucking a pit and put you to death forever, all right? Your spirit.
Psalm 137:7, remember, O Lord, the children of Edom and the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it, even to the foundation thereof.
Yeah, and that's it. The spirit, that was back in the ancient world. What about now? You know, hey, what happened when they took California, when they took New Mexico, when they took Arizona, all right? When they put Judah in slavery, when they took the Native Americans, all right? What would everybody say? Oh, good. Yeah, good for those Mexicans, good for the wetbacks, good for the Native Americans, good for the black people, all right? So same thing when new white people's kingdom starts going out, which that's why every week, every day, I clap Donald Trump, my King Donald Trump, my nigga Trump. He's destroying America, little by little, and all you white people are mad, because you're going to get snooped by all these nations. Thank your King Donald Trump for that.
O daughter of Babylon, who art to be destroyed, happy shall he be that rewarded thee as thou hast served us.
Hey, all praises and honor to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahushai, Ba'ashim, Rukah Kadosh, all right? And we're going to laugh and we're going to drink Yayan in that day, all right? Because we already see it little by little. That's where we're the prophets of the Lord. You know, hey, man, what's going on? What are people talking about right now? Two-thirds, right? Basketball, man. Two-thirds prophesy about basketball and knit. You know, they're like, what's going to happen? Oh, man, I think LeBron James has to do this. They got to do that. Warriors got to beat the Rockets. And once they get in, you know, they'll be sitting there for hours, literally just prophesying, you know, getting hella excited. Hey, we can see that with geopolitics. We can see that with the average cook, with the average heathen. We already know what's going to happen. We already prophesied. Hey, amen. You still want to fuck up, all right? You still get messed up. Then the Israelites going to win the championship, and it's going to be all good. You know, and that's what it is. The Israelites going to win the championship. Right? We're in the playoffs at this point now, all right? So, man, anybody who gets weak in this right now, man, I don't know what to say, man. We're at the fucking playoffs, bro. We're almost here. We're at the quarterfinals, bro.
Happy shall he be that taketh the dash of thy little ones against the stone.
Hey, man, that sounds crazy, right? You know, why would anybody do that? Hey, man, scripture's clearly say 2 Thessalonians 1:4, right? And it's a right, oh, right, 6. It's a righteous thing to reward. Bring it out.
It's 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahushai to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
Exactly. So there is nobody innocent, like scripture say, who has perished as being innocent. So we already know that little Edomite baby who he was in the past life. And we already know what he's going to do when he grows up, all right? You know, it sounds crazy, right? Like, oh, well, why won't you kill a little innocent kid? Hey, man, you see it with these serial killers when you watch these documentaries and shit like that. A murderer, right? Like, he was here as a little baby. You know, he's a little cute baby, you know, on the rolls and shit, you know? Right? He's all innocent, smiling and shit, you know? The Sears poster, you know? Right? And then what, 20, 30 years, he fucking becomes a serial killer, all right?
There's a movie it's about the Vikings coming to America before, which you don't know, Vikings or Kings. It's about the Vikings coming to America from the sea, encountering other natives. And then, of course, the natives, the Canaanites, were going to take that child to raise him up. And the chief told him no, because you know what he's going to become, one like them. Now, of course, they're going on. But Jake was in the spirit before he was Esau. That from the womb of the race of the people, from the demon, from the Lord is going to the womb. Esau is I can't get right. Mr. I can't get right. Miss I can't get right. You can sit there and teach him right from wrong, from a very young age. And they could be trained up in it until they get to 18. Legal age according to this song, and just go and bug out and be wild and do some crazy shit. Why? Because they're demonic in spirit, man. They're created to be demons, man. They're created that way, just like that bitch Lady Gaga has that song born this way about homosexuality, transsexuals. That's all so-called white man Esau brought to the world. Pedophilia, homosexuality, and bestiality, and violence, man. Alright?
So-called white man out, right? And what happened? America goes to the Philippines, fucks it up, makes the colony. Now the Philippines is poor. I wonder why. There was always Uncle Tom's helping out Isa. Best believe there's always Tio Tomas's helping out Tio Isisaus. Alright? Best believe, you know, Native Americans were stupid ass arrowhead tontos for helping out Isa. Pocahontas. Everybody knows the story about Pocahontas, right? Malinche, that's the Mexican Pocahontas, right? Somebody must betray somebody in the ancient world. Yeah, it's a lot. Not Judith, it's a lot. Right? But hey, we've been nothing but nice to you, right? Even to this day, man. But, hey, that's why people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because they still keep treating the white man, just as heathens, alright? The same way, like they're like we're one nation, like we're friends and shit. You know, forgetting about all the history that you done to us, right? What the white men did to us, what the Asians did to us, what the Indians did to us, what the Muslims did to us, alright? Hey. Even nothing but good to you guys, alright? Even to this day, like I said, who works the shittiest jobs at the office? Alright? The blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, right? Who works the best jobs? Alright? At Google, Facebook, and all that shit? Fucking Indians, fucking Arabs, fucking Edomites, fucking Chinese, alright? That's what you fucking see, alright? And then, what? Our people are cool with it, you know? They'll go up to a white man and be like, oh, Mr. White Man, suck up, just because he has a higher position than themselves, you know? And why is that? Again, because the white man, all right? But then our people keep on showing that, oh, I love you, Mr. White Man, keep sucking up, all right? Expecting to go somewhere by that way.
Yeah, this lamentation's one and one. How does the city sit solitary that was full of people? How has she become, as a widow, she that was great among the nations and princess among the provinces? How has she become tributary? She weepeth sore in the night, and her tears are on her cheeks. Among all her lovers she hath none to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They are become her enemies.
Hey, the scripture say, is Israel a homeborn slave? Why does Trimus now wait to seek love? All right? Because that's what our people do, man. They actually, instead of going back to Yahweh, Bashim, Yahweh, Shai, Bashim, Kakadash, has always been there for you, all right, since the beginning, all right? They rather hang out with the white man. They rather trust America. They rather trust Donald Trump, all right? They rather trust their lame-ass boss, their lame-ass fucking people they hang out in the hood with, all right? Listen to the news, all right? Instead of believing in the, except, right? Instead of following the Most High, all right, who's going to ultimately kill all these white people and destroy America and bring revenge for us, all right? Bring vengeance, all right? They're rather trusting this piece of shit world, all right? And that's why, again, they're destroyed. Bring out again, hunt for love. Right? And that's why we're desolate. That's what, you know, it's Israel, the homeborn slave. You know, why seek is that way to trim love? Trim is that way to seek love?
Yeah, Lamentations 1 and 1. How doth the city sit solitary that was full of people? How has she become as a widow? She that was great among the nations and princess among the provinces, how has she become tributary? She weepeth sore in the night and her tears are on her cheeks. Among all her lovers, she hath none to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They are become her enemies.
Yeah, that's spiritual. It's like, yeah, your spirit, where is Israel? All right? Nowhere to be found. All right? And through spirit, you know, we can clearly see that just being up here in the highways and byways, you know, we're calling Israel back into the marriage, tell them to come back to the statutes, commandments, say, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, Bashim, Karkadash, go back to the origins, you know, go back to the ways that their ancestors walked, all right? But no, they rather trust this world, all right? They rather keep on, you know, keep on following the white man again over and over again, all right?
I'll just jump to the bottom. This is verse 2, this is Lamentations 1 and 2. She weepeth sore in the night, and her tears are on her cheeks. Among all her lovers, she has none to comfort her. All her friends have dealt treacherously with her. They are become her enemies.
Yeah, exactly. And through spirit, that's what we understand why people don't come up here in the highways and byways, right? Because here it is, we're up here, and we don't see nobody. It's desolation. Where is Israel? You know, where's Israel, huh? You know, all we see is a bunch of heathens. Yeah, we see their, you know, dead bodies. We see dead Israelites, pretty much. Jesus. Oh, we see zombies. The walking dead, seeing literally ghosts, you know? Nowhere to be found, man. Exactly. And you know, that's why scripture say that, you know, the kingdom is within you, right? Because we're clearly seeing that, hey, man, the kingdom is coming back, you know? As, you know, it was desolate, but hey, little by little, you know, thanks to Ezekiel 37 chapter,
dry bones, valley of dry bones is coming back. You know, we're coming back alive. We're actually coming back into our love, like it says in Daniel 12 chapter, right? Which is what? Prophesizing the downfall of this damn-ass, lame-ass kingdom, right? This unlawful, ungodly kingdom, and pretty much bring back our people to what? To establish the kingdom of heaven, all right? Starting with us, all right? Starting with Yahweh, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai Bashim Krakadash, right? And on down, right?
Yes,
I was going to say, when it talks about all of her lovers, there's none to comfort her. Because all of her lovers, all these other nations, are benefiting off the blood, sweat, and tears of the Israelites. Which the Israelites made friends with all these other nations. And what happened? And the Lord said if we did this, then they would be thorns in our sides. And the Lord said that he would use the other nations to prove us, to see if we would follow his commandments or not. And so because Israel wanted to go and play the harlot with all these other nations, the Lord had these other nations turn against them. So all of your friends dealt treacherously, which they pursued you with the sword, they put you in slavery, they stole your lands, all right? Pretty much blotted out your name. That's what that's talking about.
Yeah. This is Lamentations chapter 5 verse 3. For thus saith the Lord of Power, the city that went out by 1,000 shall leave 100, and that which went forth by 100 shall leave 10 to the house of Israel. For thus saith the Lord unto the house of Israel, seek ye me and ye shall live. Yes, seek the Lord and ye shall live. And that's the way you seek the Lord, is by coming to his men, his prophets, supping, getting the word, getting the knowledge, man, believing, man, having faith in what we believe is the truth. But you know what? Faith is the greatest gift. You can't buy faith. Somebody can't say, hey, here, take this faith I have. No, faith is a gift that was given to a certain portion of people. Within Israel, man. Not all men have faith. Faith is shown to a person. Faith is shown by what you're willing to sacrifice. Okay? So you're supposed to seek the Lord while he may be found. Seek the Lord and he shall live. Okay? It says, for thus saith the Lord unto the house of Israel, seek ye me and ye shall live. Okay, because a lot of you people are getting gunned down, destroyed. Why? Because you don't have any knowledge, man. These people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Because you're not seeking the Lord. You're too busy seeking after your own will, after your own heart's desire, after your own lust, which is Satan, man. Okay? You're seeking after your own pleasures, not the pleasures of the Lord. Alright? It says, but seek not Bethel, nor enter into Gilgal, and pass not to Beersheba, for Gilgal shall surely go into captivity, and Bethel shall come to naught. And our people are always searching, going into other cities, going into other doctrines, worshiping other gods. And America is going to go into captivity, man. America's going to be taken with the sword at the end of the day, man. But before that, there's going to be martial law, which is the captivity, man. They're going to shut these streets down. They start killing the people.
That's right!
It says, yeah, this is at verse 6. Seek the Lord and ye shall live, lest he break out like fire in the house of Joseph and devour it, and there be none to quench it but them. Yeah, so you know, you gotta seek the Lord, man. Why it may be found that you live. At least you break out in fire, man. Because the Lord is gonna devour the earth, and his wrath is jealousy, man. He's gonna devour America in jealousy, man. So you gotta seek the Lord, you gotta say, hey, well, what can I do? What can I do? So that I don't get burned. So that my children don't get burned. So that my wife don't die, man. What can I do to please you, to serve you? I don't want to be burnt up. I don't want you to judge me in that way. Because everybody's going to get judged. The elect are going to get judged. They're going to be judged personally. So you got all these reprobates. Which one is the real Spider-Man? Which one? They're all phony. Plato, just like America.
Right!
just some bullshit country, bullshit. Bullshit, corporation. Because America isn't a country, it's a corporation. Alright? It says, lest the Lord break out like a fire in the house of Joseph, man. The house of Joseph is Latinos, man. And Native Americans. And you realize how the Lord broke out against the Northern Kingdom a lot, man. You know? How the Lord broke out against the house, against the Northern Kingdom a lot, man. The Lord was always checking up the Northern Kingdom, man. Why? Because you're the most rebellious out of the whole nation, man. You're the most wicked out of the whole nation, because you are the majority of the nation, man. Now, of course, there was always an elective of the Northern. There was always so-called good people of the Northern Kingdom. You know? But the majority of the North was wicked, man. You know? And the Lord gonna break out in that fire amongst the whole nation of Israel, the way he was against the North. Killing their kings left and right. Are bringing famines upon them. Sending a whole bunch of nations against them at every angle. It was so bad to where they had to make leagues with other nations. You know? And what did the Lord do? He even used those same nations to take them away. You know? The Lord gonna break out on Israel at all angles, man. The race is in Israel, man.
The nations that
you love
so much.
Hey, man. They're going to be losing power. So who's still Hamas's God? Jezreel. White Jesus. The white man. The blame stirrings, man. Goddamn deal Hamas is in Tomahawk. You believe the so-called white man is God, man. You believe in that Jezreel fortune is so-called Jesus Christ. Alright? This is your savior, man. First thing that comes to mind is the idea of the white man. Isaiah chapter 31:31. Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me.
Exactly. Rebellious children. Which rebellious children? I'm not talking about other nations. Talking about children. You know, because when you have a child, what? You have a father. You have a mother, right? So, hey, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai Bashim, Kakadash is a father, right? And we're his children, right? And that's what he's talking about. He's taking us. You know, instead of going back to daddy, right? Go back to our father. We'd rather go back to these strange ass people. Gods, these different friends, right? What? They have done nothing but treacherously against us, right? Through all history, right? Back from the ancient world to the back in the womb, even since the womb, all right? All the way till now, you know. But again, our people, you know, they can't think of a better tomorrow. They can't think of a different lifestyle. This is the epitome of life. This is the meaning of life. Me walking around San Jose, on Santa Clara Street, and Market Street, touching a bunch of boxes. But walking by the bus stop, that's the meaning of life. I did it. I figured it out.
I'm a slave.
I'm a goddamn mojado for the white man. Alright?
You know, I bring it up. He says, but not of me, and that cover what they cover, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin.
Exactly. Instead of going back to the statutes, commandments, going to non-GMO food, you'd rather eat fucking GMO food all day, every day. Alright? Which again, you might as well eat. Just like these philosophies, these doctrines, those are GMOs, man. Those ain't real. What do GMOs do to you? They utterly fuck up your system, all right? They mess up your stomach, all right? The bacteria in your stomach, all right? And what happens after that? Then you get colon cancer. What happens after that? Then you get all the other diseases, you know?
all the favorite diseases that our tribes love to get. Diabetes, high cholesterol, you know, the fucking cancer, you know, the gout, you know, you name it, man. Our people have it, right?
Our people love diabetes.
Our people love diabetes, man.
They love it, all right? You can tell your family because you're eating all that pork.
Nah, I can't be that.
You're eating all that shit.
I don't eat it every day, huh? I don't eat it every day.
Maybe that's what I'll tell you. But I don't eat it every day. It don't matter, man.
Drinking every damn day.
It don't matter.
All that soda.
Oh, man. You know that soda? And we're not sorry. Death to you.
That's right.
You know, drinking all that soda, man. Jake loves soda, man. And that's just poison, man. You look it up, so what soda is, like Coca-Cola, it's actually like boiled shit, man. And other chemicals.
Bullshit.
You know, and people drink it. It's like, bro, you shouldn't be drinking it. Jake, they know the scripture. He might blow out Ezekiel on you. I mean, my defiled bread on. It's like, no, man, the Lord don't want you to eat that shit, man. You know, I mean, it's bad enough we go to the store. You might get some juice that says 100% juice. It's probably not even real juice, man. It says made from concentrate, you know?
Yep.
It's not real.
Exactly.
And but it's still better than drinking soda.
Yep. And why are people so easily eased into that? Why do they, you know, we tell them, they see the articles, right? That's it. Why is it? Everything is telling you the contrary of what you're doing. And yet Castillo Tomas, right? Uncle Tom, all right? Your daddy Esau, the white man, tells you the other way around. You'd rather go to the hospital, the doctor. You'd rather get hooked up on some opioids, all right? Right? Our people rather be on opioids and trust in the Lord. They go to get herbs, all right? And again, because they trust the so-called white men, right? They wouldn't be doing most of this shit if it wasn't they have a leader telling them what to do. Who's their leader right now? Who's their God? Who's their power? Cesar Borgia, all right? Ultimately, the white men.
Isaiah 29:16, surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. For shall the work say of him that made it, he may be not? Or shall the thing framed say of him that framed it, he hath no understanding?
Turning things upside down. And that's what Esau does, right? Because you notice how in this world, everything's opposite to scriptures, all right? You know? And why is that? Because Esau designed it that way, all right? He designed it for us to constantly keep going on and on, all right? What's foul is now a delicacy, right? Shrimp, pork, right? Your meat not being cooked fully all the way. You know, that's a delicacy, you know? What's the fish? Shrimp, crab, yeah, all these.
Lobster,
yeah, you see all these? Shark, hey, you gonna be cheap, you got a Red Lobster, tell you that much right now, you're paying $100 at least once you're done there, all right? For what? For eating a bunch of garbage, all right? But because things are turned upside down, hey, you're a king now because you're eating fucking lobster.
Yeah, testimony, right? I was talking to this dumbass bitch, damn dumbass, Cerote bitch, man, and she was talking about, she was like, oh, I didn't come to work yesterday. I was like, I noticed. She was like, oh, yeah, I got sick. But she was talking to me about how she fucking had a feast at like a buffet for eating seafood, man.
Oh, shit.
And when she was talking about it, I was like, yeah, gross the fuck out. Like, I don't want to talk to this bitch. You know? Now, of course, Jake got to get boxed wherever. You got to do what you got to do. You know? But you get disgusted by it.
Going right.
Like, if that was my woman, I couldn't have that shit. She told me she got sick, and I told her, and I scoffed, I righteously scoffed. I said, it's because of all that shrimp you ate, man. All that seafood you ate. And she burst out, started laughing. She knew it was true. The next day, she comes to work and talks about she falls sick. And then I was like, well, what'd you eat? And she said she ate pork. Army people are beguiled by this damn devil, man. Alright? They're beguiled by the ways of this world.
Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Yeah, they're destroyed for a lack of knowledge, man. Our people don't know better. And we out here to tell you what's better. We out here to tell you what's good, what's true. But you deny it, alright? You don't want it. It's just like you might be starving to death or thirsty to the point of death. Thirsty to the point of death, come up to you with a bottle of water. Not just any water. That high pH water that comes in glass bottles. They come up to you with that. We about to crack it open and see you dying before it. You roll over and start putting sand in your mouth. You might be in the desert dying of thirst. We are over there pouring the water on you. We about to. You roll over and put sand in your mouth. That's how our people are, man. Destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
The information's right in front of you, so it really is no excuse except you surrender me, really.
We hit you with the scripture, and then we pull out evidence. It is a well-known fact, even according to Esau, that when our people eat these debaucherous foods, these bad foods, they start developing ailments in their body. Why is it that these other nations do it and nothing happens to them? Because their the laws, statutes, commandments weren't given to them other nations, man. They were given to our people, man. The Lord said, Amos 3.
I got it.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you. All the children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth, therefore I will punish you for all your iniquities.
Exactly, and back to the covenant, right? You know, that's what Yahweh Shai said to the lost sheep of Israel, right? I come for them, not for the world, all right? So ultimately, it's all about Jacob, all right? And that's what the Spirit, we're the greatest nation for that. We got the most help from all these nations, all right? You know, both sides balance. He ain't going to give you the best and then not give you the worst. No, he gives you the best and then you're going to catch the worst slavery. You know, and the worst slavery was here in America. No other nation, the history of the world, there's no history book you can pick up and ever going to compare it to what the white man did to the blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. And what, they think they can just walk around and think nothing bad's going to happen? Karma's going to come back, all right? But again, that's why our nation gets jacked up, all right? And ultimately, why we went down to Esau? Because again, it's because Yahweh Shai has a special favor upon us, all right? Just like the brothers always bring out the example. Hey, man, is that your kid? Why are you worrying about it? Is that your kid? I'm not paying for his diapers. I'm not paying for his rent. I'm not taking care of it. Why would I care about somebody else's kids? You know, I didn't raise them, you know? All right? So hey, that's the scoffers, bro. But yeah, you only care about your kid, you know? You don't give a fuck. You know, daycare and shit. Hey, I'm gonna call your mom. Hey, and I say, I'm gonna call somebody else's mom. I'm gonna call your mom, all right? And that's the same thing with us, all right?
Because we're under the law of God. So the Lord is going to punish his people for their iniquities, for their sins. That's why I brought it out. These other nations don't get jacked up when they eat these bad foods, when they do all these wicked acts, okay? But our people do. Our people get jacked up. They get the gout. They get diabetes. They get heart failure. Okay? That's why.
If I had not come and spoken unto them, they had not sinned. But now they have no cloak for their sin.
Exactly. Hey, that's what we get on the highways and byways.
St. John 15:22, if I had not come and spoken unto them, they had not had sin, but now they have no cloak for their sin.
Exactly, hey, that's why, ultimately, right? That's why it's plain and it's clear as day that, you know, that we have to be the man of the Lord, all right? Because no one else is going out there preaching the word and putting it in, you know, put in your face to make the scripture come true that, hey man, you heard the word, you saw the prophets, all right? Everybody's seen YouTube, everybody's seen the videos of the apostles or any other camp, you know? You can't avoid it at this point, just like you can't avoid rap music, you know? 6ix9ine and shit. Maybe you can't avoid the truth, man. It's viral, all right? So again, that's why that scripture is coming to pass. The way it is here, you know? And there is no excuse, all right? At this point, especially for our people, all right? It's only playing upon tables. What you have to do to escape this wrath, but yet our people don't, you know? Reprobate, ultimately, at the end of the day, whether it be with their dietary laws, their lifestyles, their decisions they make, their beliefs, everything. It's all off. It's all against the Most High, ultimately.
This is Romans chapter 6, verse 23. For the wages of sin is death.
And the wages of sin is death, exactly. Everything that's contrary to everything against the scriptures is pretty much GMO, alright? You know, again, hippies always talk about, hey, we should go back to normal nature at this specificity. Let's go back to harmony. Let's go back to nature.
So we're right? Born in the sky, we're now into the dead.
So basically, you know, we're trying to tell people, hey, go back to non-GMO, man. You know, go back to the original. Stop eating McDonald's, you know? Spiritual McDonald's. Which what? America is spiritual McDonald's. In every facet of the way you look at
so
it, right?
So which one of the 12 tribes went back into the desert?
This is Romans chapter 6, verse 23. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of the Most High is eternal life through Yahushua Mashiach, our Lord.
Exactly. So that's why we know, hey, the scriptures have everything. Your dietary laws, all right? Your lifestyle, how to conduct yourself, all right? Which power to worship, how to worship Him, all right? And that's life, all right? Isn't that why the scriptures say, hey, sin is death, all right? The wages of sin are death, all right? And that's what it is, because everything else in this life right here is contrary to scriptures. It's against life. It's against nature.
So, that's lucky. You go to work, you earn a wage.
Yeah, that's the spirit I was just thinking.
You go to work, you earn a wage. If you commit sin, well, the wage, the payment for that sin is death, man. Now, there is sins that are unto death, and there's sins that you go back to. Okay? You don't commit the sins unto death. We're out here telling you, don't do those. Don't do any sin. But we're in the flesh. You might have to put money in your gas tank in the Sabbath. You broke the law, but you can repent of that. Okay? But the wages of sin of eating these fruits, that's why our people get sick. That's why they get jacked. Okay? That's why our people can't be sick. But breaking the law leads to death.
It also means that life is mostly in jail too. Do a reprobate shit, right? You know, just wilding out, and next thing you know, they're fucking in the dungeon.
Yeah, because I mean, you gotta keep. Yeah, the scriptures tell you to keep even the powers that be's commandments when it comes to other laws.
Romans 13.
Certain of them. Romans 13. Yeah. Powers that be. And some of them are common sense, like red lights. Okay, you don't want to run a red light. You get smacked by another car that got green. That got the green light. Alright? You don't just go out there and fucking steal things. Because even according to our law, you can't steal. Okay? You know, there's certain common sense laws that even Esau got.
Yeah, because there's certain laws that Esau has that are lawful in the scriptures that you can't do here. You go ahead and break the commandments of the Edomites and see what they do.
The Lord told me to. You know, hey man, you're going in the hole, bro.
Yeah.
You know, there's no way around it.
Yeah, this is St. John 3:19. And this is the condemnation that light is come into the world. And men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil.
In the spirit, that's why we don't see Israelites here, man. I mean, we see 2/3 of Israelites everywhere walking up and down. But hey, where the men of the Lord at, man? America's about to be destroyed by getting nuked by Iran and North Korea. And what is everybody else telling them? You know, Russia and Russia too. All right, India gonna throw nukes in this place too. All right,
that
bend the bow. All right, but where are the watchmen? You know, where are the people sounding the alarm? You know, in the streets and the highways and byways. You know, it's not the goddamn Jehovah's Witnesses just looking, staring at you in an awkward way. You know, no, it's us telling you the scriptures, bring it out. You know, so, whatever question we were able to answer, right? You know, whether it be for condemnation or for your salvation. You know, ultimately. But that's what we're doing, man, going out on the highways and byways, all right, and telling people to come back to the fold. But because this lifestyle, people are so into this lifestyle, literally live it, you know, believe in it, that they can't possibly imagine them doing this. Like, what benefit is that for me? You know, what am I going to gain for especially on a Saturday? Oh, best believe, right? A Babylonian giveaway this Saturday? You know? Oh, hell no. This is my Saturday. Tell me I've been working all week, Monday through Friday, catch nothing but hell. And I can't go to the club on Saturday? And I have to go preach to work? Oh, hell no.
St. John 14 and 1, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in the Most High, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you.
God, exactly, and that's what we're doing this, because we actually believe that this is what Yahweh HaShem Yahweh Shaifa Shimmer Kakadash, you know, requires from us, all right, to get that reward, all right? Because we don't want the reward, we don't want to win the lottery, you know, we don't want to go on permanent vacation. I don't want to fucking be here anymore, man. Be around a bunch of heathens and shit, having to fucking dodge glances on the train, all right? You know, that's all Jake does. Jake just dodging glances, literally. Why? Because we're just a proverb, we're just a byword, you know, which is an astonishment to all these nations, you know? Best believe, you know, anywhere Jake goes, everybody starts looking at Jake. Everybody starts acting a certain type of way, you know? Comfortable here, no one's your buddy here. Everybody pretends to talk to you just because they have to be nice, right? But they really don't like you. They wish you were dead, really, you know? Especially when Jake be winning. You know, Esau wants Jake dead as soon as he sees Jake winning, you know?
Hey, Jake wants Jake dead when Jake sees Jake winning.
Well, enough said.
You know, these two-thirds want to see certain men of the Lord dead, okay? A lot of them, actually a lot, majority, two-thirds. Two-thirds of our people want to see us dead.